Peggy 12.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Nintendo Direct. Today I'm going to share more information about games coming to Europe in the next few months. And I'd like to start by taking a look at some Nintendo 3DS games. Let's begin right away by looking at some of the characters in The Legend of Zelda: A Link Between Worlds in more detail. First, I'd like to show you a completely new character, Irene the Witch. Maybe you spotted her already in another trailer. From the beginning of the game, you will sometimes see her flying overhead. She comes in useful later, when someone tells her that helping out someone wearing green will bring good fortune. And so she offers our hero some help in his travels. After that, you can touch this bell on the lower screen, pick the location you want to travel to, from a list of weather vanes you've found, and then Irene's magic broom will show up to take Link there. Just like Link, Irene's magic broom itself can travel between two worlds and pick him up even when he's in the dark world, known as Lorule. The next character I want to talk about is Ceres, the daughter of the sanctuary's priest. She's a beautiful girl and a gentle soul, so she is a perfect target for a Zelda villain. And Yuga has definitely noticed her. If you've seen our most recent trailers, you may have seen the evil wizard trap Ceres inside a painting. This next item should be familiar to Zelda fans. Wearing Zora's flippers and using Link's swimming skill is the only way to properly meet today's third character. After swimming in Lake Hylia, you may find a bottle with a message about milk in it. Fans will definitely remember the milk bar from The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. And this time, there's a milk bar in Hyrule too. Talk to the owner and he will tell you that the man who disappeared into the mountain has a deep affection for premium milk. Sounds like a side quest, doesn't it? Now, let me introduce you to a nice old man named Gramps. Talk to him and you will be able to engage in special battles against players you met through Street Pass. First, you create your own Shadow Link that will be sent to others via Street Pass. The bounty on your Shadow Link's head will increase depending on the items you have equipped and how many hearts you have. After that, your Shadow Link data will be sent to anyone you meet, and their data will be sent to you. Soon after, their Shadow Link will appear at certain places in your game world. This is a good opportunity to earn lots of rupees, which you will need to rent or buy important items from Ravio's shop. So I hope you will try battling lots of people via Street Pass. Now here is a brand new trailer for you.
Thank you.
The Legend of Zelda: A Link Between Worlds will launch in shops and in Nintendo eShop on November 22nd. Don't forget that this limited edition Nintendo 3DS XL system will also be released on the same day. As previously announced, Bravely Default is coming to Europe on December 6th. Bravely Default is a highly anticipated RPG from Square Enix, where you must battle through a dangerous world filled with possibilities. Today, I would like to talk to you about some of the brand new features that it introduces. First, you can disrupt the flow of combat with the revolutionary Brave and Default system. Select the default option to have your character shield themselves for a turn. This increases their defense and builds up Brave points. Then select Brave to spend your Brave points. This allows your character to hit multiple times in one turn, devastating your enemy. You can even use Brave if you don't have any Brave points by borrowing them from a future turn. Use the Bravely second feature to freeze time during battle. Press the start button to stop time at any point in a battle and attack in a time freeze. Attacks during the Bravely second use 3 points rather than Brave points. You can leave your Nintendo 3DS system in sleep mode while playing Bravely Default to build up more sleep points. In Bravely Default, you can customize your characters with a vast range of jobs, abilities, weapons, and spells. Discover the best way to defeat tough enemies by finding your own strategy. Once you have your strategy figured out, you can increase the pace of combat with a plus control pad for even faster battles. Nintendo 3DS also allows you to street pass your friends in different ways. You can summon them into battle to help you out in tough situations, or they can help rebuild your hometown after it's swallowed by the great chasm. Bravely Default is an epic adventure with many places and quests to explore, and many hours of gameplay to enjoy. It will be available from shops in Europe on December 6th. I would also like to tell you more about our Bravely Default Deluxe Collector's Edition. This will also be available on December 6th from participating retailers. Finally, I'm pleased to tell you that you can download a demo of Bravely Default from Nintendo eShop shortly after this presentation ends. The demo is only available in English, but of course, the full Bravely Default game will be available in other European languages when it is released. Next is a game coming to Europe next year, Mario Party Island Tour. Mario's latest party has a tropical theme, with 7 new game boards and 80 new mini-games, all of which are designed with portable play in mind. Mini-games have always been at the heart of Mario Party. So let's look at one of the mini-game modes. Time Attack is a single-player mode that has you playing 10 mini-games in a row as fast as you can. If you complete special objectives, you can even lower your overall time by 3 seconds each. Back in April, we told you a little about another single-player mode, a mini-game tower. This is Bowser's Tower, which pits you against Bowser and his minions in 30 floors of minigame madness. Every 5 floors, you will face a boss battle, like a Goomba Tower attack or a Chain Chomp showdown. These tough challenges will really test your skills. Of course, Mario Party is most fun in multiplayer, and this new title offers another way to compete against other players with Street Pass minigames. You can Street Pass up to 10 other players and compete against their Street Pass data the next time you play the game. Another new addition to the party is motion controls. They create a whole new set of minigames that are only possible on Nintendo 3DS. You can flash ghosts with a torch, steer marbles, or even control a hang glider. And with download play, 4 players can play together with just one game card between them. Mario Party Island Tour arrives on Nintendo 3DS in Europe on January 17th next year. As you know, Inazuma 11 3 Lightning Bolt and Inazuma 11 3 Bomb Blast recently launched on Nintendo 3DS. As the head of the Inazuma national team, you have to recruit, train, and trade the best players possible to become the ultimate champions of the world. Today, I can announce that Inazuma 11 3 Team Ogre Attacks will also be launched in Europe on February 14th for Nintendo 3DS. In Team Ogre Attacks, you follow the story of Canon Evans, the great-grandson of Mark Evans from the future, as you set your sights on becoming footballing world champion. You will be able to face and recruit unique opponents, such as the formidable Team Ogre, attain unique special moves, and take part in an exclusive tournament. You will also be able to connect with Inazuma 11 3 Lightning Bolt and Inazuma 11 3 Bomb Blast via the new Ogre Premium Link to receive special items and rare players not available through normal gameplay. Start training today on Inazuma 11 3 Lightning Bolt and Bomb Blast and get ready to complete the Inazuma 11 3 experience next year with the launch of Inazuma 11 3 Team Ogre Attacks on February 14, 2014. Next, I have some information regarding YouTube. Today I can confirm YouTube is coming to Nintendo 3DS. With your Nintendo 3DS, as long as you have internet access, you can easily view videos when you are on the go. You can even search for contents on the bottom screen while watching a different video on the top screen. The YouTube application on Wii U is also receiving an upgrade. This upgrade will greatly improve the interface. Now you will be able to view videos on the Wii U gamepad or search for contents on the gamepad while watching a different video on your television screen. I hope you look forward to this update. Next, I have information about the Nintendo 3DS system update we are planning to release next month. For some time now, we've been receiving feedback from our customers who own both a Wii U and a Nintendo 3DS. These owners wish they could combine the remaining balances from their Nintendo eShop accounts on Nintendo 3DS and Wii U. And now, we can finally accommodate that request. With this system update, you can register your Nintendo Network ID on your Nintendo 3DS. This will enable you to share Nintendo eShop balance information from the Wii U registered to your Nintendo Network ID. If you register the same Nintendo Network ID on both your Nintendo 3DS and Wii U, you can purchase software on either device using a combined balance. After the system update has been distributed, we will ask that you create a Nintendo Network ID to download game demos or other free software. Also, After the update, you will still be able to download paid contents without logging in with your Nintendo Network ID. That way, you can continue to access and use the remaining balance already registered on your hardware without creating a new Nintendo Network ID. However, if you register the wrong Nintendo Network ID by mistake, or register a different Nintendo Network ID to the one you use on Wii U, you will not be able to combine your balances. Please be careful and make sure you choose the right Nintendo Network ID. Moving forward, we will continue to improve our offerings with Nintendo Network IDs. Eventually, more of our services will use them, so we hope you feel encouraged to create your own ID. One of those new services is Miiverse on Nintendo 3DS, which will start alongside this system update. With your Nintendo Network ID, you will be able to connect with players around the world to share your experiences and game tips through Miiverse on Nintendo 3DS. If you didn't try Miiverse yet, it's a way to share screenshots, handwritten messages, and comments with other players all over the world, which we launched with Wii U. As there are already hundreds of Nintendo 3DS games available, not all of them will have communities at first, but more communities will be added over time. You can find out more information about Miiverse for Nintendo 3DS at our official website. Please take a look. Now I'd like to turn our attention to titles coming to Nintendo eShop soon on Nintendo 3DS. Some of you may know this next character from the first Jet Rocket game on WiiWare. Well, now the sequel is coming to Nintendo 3DS. In Jet Rocket 2, The Last of Taikai, you explore the power plant boss's home world in a combination of 2D and 3D platforming. Use your trusty jetpack to cross gaps, race across water on your jet boat, and much more, all at a smooth 60 frames per second. There are plenty of hidden secrets and multiple gameplay modes to unlock. Can you find them all? Jet Rocket 2, The Last of Taikai will be available to download shortly after this presentation. There are lots more great games coming to Nintendo eShop. Take a look at this. Now I'd like to tell you about a brand new game for Nintendo 3DS, coming to Nintendo eShop in Europe next year. It's called Nintendo Pocket Football Club. In Nintendo Pocket Football Club, you'll create, customize, and manage your own football team. Choose your country, emblem, and kit. Then get on the pitch and take your players up through the leagues to the top division. As manager, you need to decide on your tactics, buy and sell players in the transfer market, and build up the stats of your current team by focusing on areas to improve and boosting your players' skills. Watch from the sidelines as your tactics play out, and then celebrate your success. Or head back to the manager's office to rethink your game plan. Nintendo Pocket Football Club features many ways to play. You can dive into single-player mode, play local wireless matches, and participate against friends and fellow players across Europe in an online multiplayer mode. We are going to be telling you more about this game over the coming months, so stay tuned. Now, for some Wii U updates, starting with Animal Crossing Plaza. As many of you already know, this free download works together with Miiverse to create an Animal Crossing series community. There, you can comment about your favorite villagers, post screenshots of events happening in your town, and interact with other Animal Crossing players from all over the world. In order to make your interaction with other players in Animal Crossing Plaza even better, we will now update the software to include two new features. After the update, you will be able to add in special stamps when posting on Miiverse. There are over 50 unique stamps based on Animal Crossing items and characters. You can combine multiple stamps or add a hand-drawn message to the post with a stamp. You can also erase part of the stamp and add on your own design, so you can easily create some really interesting and imaginative posts. These stamps are something we have already revealed as a feature in the upcoming Super Mario 3D World for Wii U. We will also introduce Miiverse stamps for more titles in the future, in addition to Animal Crossing Plaza. Please stay tuned. By the way, these stamps can only be used on the specific titles' dedicated community, so you will not be able to use them in the communities of other titles. The other new addition included in the update is a poll feature. Each month, we will present a set of rankings for players to enjoy based on the result of various polls in Animal Crossing Plaza. November's themed question is who would make the best secretary, and December's theme will be who is the neighbor of the year. In Animal Crossing Plaza, polling will cover a variety of themes and take place every month from now until the plaza closes at the end of 2014. I hope you plan on participating. We will be adding more features to Animal Crossing Plaza as well, like resident registration. This allows you to register all of your town's residents, so you can meet them in the plaza anytime you want. To make this software more enjoyable to use, the update will also improve how albums work. You will soon be able to move and delete multiple pictures simultaneously, and save pictures attached to Miiverse post to your albums. Whether you've been enjoying the software already or you haven't visited Animal Crossing Plaza, I hope you consider this a good opportunity to download it and enjoy the update features. The Animal Crossing Plaza update will be released early tomorrow morning, November 14th. Now, I have news regarding a future downloadable content for Pikmin 3. For this title, we are releasing additional stages for mission mode that will task you to lead your Pikmin efficiently to complete as many tasks as possible within the time limit. In addition to Volume 1's Collect Treasure, Download Contents, and Volume 2, Battle Enemies, we will release a third volume for Mission Mode that contains additional stages as well. In previous releases, these add-on stages were altered versions of courses that appeared in Mission Mode and Story Mode, with new placement of fruit, creatures, and traps. That's hopefully encouraged players to think up new strategies. However, the levels, including in Volume 3, will be completely new stages. These include natural environments like beaches, as well as man-made locations like the inside of someone's house during a party, a construction site, or a mysterious factory. There is even a stage in which you control Captain Olima, who is a main character from Pikmin 1 and 2, as well as a veteran Pikmin tamer. In Volume 3, some of the rules have been changed as well. Somewhere in the stage, Olima's friend Rui is hiding. If you find him and let your Pikmin take him back to the base, you'll be able to control Rui as well. The more characters you have under your control, the easier it becomes to divide your Pikmin into groups, so you can complete tasks more efficiently. If you are aiming for the highest score possible, Rui will be a great asset to you. In order to fine-tune your strategy, it is very important to decide which route to take and when to add Rui to the party, while gathering the Pikmin scattered all over the stage. I wish you good luck. Pikmin 3 Mission Mode Add-on Stage Volume 3 includes a total of 8 stages, 4 Collect Treasures stages and 4 Battle Enemies stages. It will be released on December 2nd. On the same day this new add-on content arrives, we will also release the software update that is required to play it. So please make sure to update your software first. I'd also like to remind you about 2 new games you can enjoy on Wii U today. On November 1st, we made available the 31-day free trial version of Wii Fit U. You can download the game from Nintendo eShop for free and try out all its features and exercise for 31 days, using your existing Wii Balance Board. If you enjoy the game, you can pair a fit meter to keep playing with no time limitations. If you own a Wii U and a Wii Balance Board, I hope you will download this free trial and try it for yourself. For more information, please visit our Wii Fit U website. Wii Sports Club is another game available as a free download from Nintendo eShop. You can enjoy classic Wii Sports events like tennis and bowling, updated with Wii Remote Plus controls, online play, and Miiverse features. You can play the game free for 24 hours, beginning when you start the software for the first time. If you want to keep playing, you can purchase a 24-hour day pass, or keep playing your favorite sports as long as you like with a single sport pass. Please choose the option that suits you. Finally today, I'd like to leave you with something I hope you will enjoy. If you are a Nintendo Direct regular, then you already know Super Mario 3D World brings Mario, Luigi, Princess Peach, and Toad, each with special abilities to Wii U. You also know it will be the first multiplayer Mario platformer set in a three-dimensional world. But there is still a lot more to say about the game. Here are 10 more things you need to see in Super Mario 3D World, even including some unlockable contents you have been warned. Super Mario 3D World will be released for Wii U on November 29th, both in stores and in Nintendo eShop. I hope that video will tide you over until the game is available. That's our last update for today. I hope you enjoyed this Nintendo Direct, and thanks for watching. Happy gaming!